Children, good afternoon.
Ma'am, your voice is
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Which is this class?
English.
Okay. Which standard? Which standard? Fourth standard. Okay. Can you see the screen? I have shared something. What do you see?
Festivals. Ma'am, festivals.
Okay, mute your system. Mute your system. Mute your system and don't open your camera. Today we are going to study about a new place. We are going to study about a new place and its festival. So where are we going today? Today no books, no studies. We are just going to go on a virtual trip to Uttarakhand. Where are we going? We are going to a virtual trip to Uttarakhand. And what are we learning from there? What are we learning? We are learning about the festivals. Mute your system and finger on your lips. If you speak in between, I will leave the meeting. As it is, this is the last session. You are also tired, I am also tired. But if you cooperate, this class is going to be very fruitful and you will enjoy watching this PPT. So I don't want any disturbance, I don't want any unwanted extraordinary talks. Just come and enjoy this virtual trip to Uttarakhand. Standard 4 English, virtual trip to Uttarakhand. And the topic is festivals. I hope all have seen on the screen the first slide that is being showing there. That is, it is all about the festivals. The festivals that is being celebrated in Uttarakhand. Okay? Uttarakhand, in the second slide, you see there's an image of goddess sitting on the lotus. Next to that you can see the statue of Lord Shiva. Uttarakhand, it is also called as the land of gods. It's only because many temples are there and many pilgrimages go there to visit these beautiful temples. And they offer puja and perform rituals there. Uttarakhand has the nickname Dev Bhumi. It is called as Dev Bhumi. Uttarakhand has the nickname Dev Bhumi, meaning the land of the gods. It was formerly called Uttaranchal. Earlier it was called Uttaranchal. It was called as Uttaranchal, but now it is renamed as Uttarakhand. Okay, now this is a map of India. You can see a red portion here. This is Uttarakhand. And the date of formation from Uttaranchal, it was transformed or renamed to Uttarakhand on 9th November 2000. 9th November 2000, the formation of Uttaranchal to Uttarakhand. Okay, now I'll show you some images of the famous or important festival celebrated in the in this state, that is the Uttarakhand. You can see these ladies carrying beautifully dressed with a colorful pots on their head with flowers. And you can see to your left side, there is some procession going on. So these are all different kinds of festivals. You can see here, the people are in large number gathered. They are going on a procession. A procession, they are going to the temple. They are going to offer some prayer and perform some rituals during some festivals. Yes, these are the temples which you will always find. The temples are located on the hills, on the hilly region or the mountain. Okay, see, this is the mountain and you can see the white patches there. You can see the white patches here. These are the roads. You can see the temples here. This is the temple. This is the temple which you can see here. So this is a mountain and this is the road which goes to this temple. You can see here people performing many tricks on the roads to attract people, to attract the public, to entertain the people during the festivals. You can see here the men are wearing some colorful dresses and they're performing some type of gymnastics where people get attracted and they like to watch it. Okay, the next festival, what we are going to view or watch is Full Day Festival. It is a harvest festival. It is a significant harvest festival in Uttarakhand. Full Day is a reverence paid to the gods for the good crop. It is on this occasion, little girls decorate the threshold of the houses with freshly picked flowers. You can see here, this festival also called as the harvest festival. They are showing their gratitude. They are thanking God for showing His mercy on them because of the weather, favorable weather and the climate, and also for the rain, because of all these factors, the crop yield or the production of crop increases. You can see here the little girls, they are collecting flowers. Yes, and they are going to go to the temples and they are going to offer these flowers to the god or goddesses because of the festival that is the harvest. We are saying thank you to God. Next is the Holi festival, a colorful festival made more colorful with distinct folk songs and music. Uttarakhand Holi marks the state's rich culture and a specific style to do things differently. Okay, now the people, when they celebrate Holi here, they celebrate it in a very different way. Like Holi as the festival celebrates the joy of togetherness, culture and color that adds more meaning and happiness. This vibrant festival is extravagantly roasted over a period of 2 months in Kumaon. Okay, so they celebrate this with full interest, with full happiness, and not only that, they share their happiness with their friends and neighbors and relatives. You can see the excitement, how people are engrossed in celebrating Holi. As it is, Holi is a festival of colors, but here people enjoy it to the fullest. Harila and Bitauli festival. This festival is celebrated 4 times in the year in the Kumaon region of Uttarakhand. Hareli and Bitauli marks itself an important folk festival in which prayers are offered for prosperity of crops. Again, this is related with agriculture, crops production. So, 4 times in a year they celebrate this festival to show their gratitude to God for showing His mercy and showering His blessings on them for the production of food crops. What they do here, the grains, what they sow, and when a tiny saplings come, they offer this to the God. You can see here, these are all the photos of gods. Yes, they have offered coconut, sweet, and they have offered this to the God as a gratitude because God shows His mercy, God shows His blessings on them and they will prosper. See here again, they have lit the lamp, oil lamp, and they are offering this small grains what they have sown. They have got small tiny saplings. Okay, they will show this or offer it in the temple or put it in front of God to show how grateful they are to God for helping them to grow more crops so that they don't have any problem. The next one is the Ganga Dashera festival. Ganga Dashera festival commemorating the descent of river Ganga on earth. This religious festival is when the devotees have an opportunity to take a dip in the water of this holy river in Haridwar and Rishikesh to cleanse their soul and all their sins. Now, everybody knows Ganga is a holy river. People go once in a year to take a dip in the holy Ganga. They go there to take a dip so that they clear their sins, to wash away their sins. And everybody knows the Ganga flows from the high mountains and reaches the earth. And if you read the story, mythological stories, you will understand why Ganga flows from the mountain to the earth. Now, people in Haridwar and Rishikesh, on the banks of the river, on the banks of the river Ganga, they perform puja. And how do they perform? They go, people from all over the country go there, they take a dip, they take a bath in the river Ganga, and then they go to the temple and they offer their puja, thinking that their sins are washed away. Now they have become a pure person, that is a holy person. Yes, you can see. And when they go, you can see here, see the people here, the crowd, they come, they take a bath and they go to the temple and they offer. And flowers and light and all is been offered to the river Ganga, asking river Ganga to wash away their sins and to make them clean and pure again. So many people, many Hindus especially, at least once in their lifetime, they would like to go to this place and become a part of it. I mean to say, they go there with full devotion, thinking that once if they go, whatever sin they have committed or whatever mistake they have committed, it will be forgiven and they become a holy person. The next one is the Ghee Sankratri festival. Marking the harvest season, Ghee Sankratri in Uttarakhand is a way to demonstrate gratitude for the agricultural prosperity. It is also a festival of savoring delectable ghee prepared dishes as well. And about Ghee Sankratri festival, which is known as Olgiya festival, is celebrated on the first day of Badau, the month of August in Uttarakhand. It is one of the most important festival in the state, which is celebrated with a lot of enthusiasm and joy from time immemorial. Okay, now I will show you. You can see this is a clay pot, and what you can see, this yellow color structure is the pure ghee. Pure ghee, it is being offered in the puja. And you can see here, people have offered coconut, different 5 types of fruits, flowers, this is sugar cane. So again, it is related with agricultural products. So they are always thankful to God for showing His mercy on them. This is the clay pot and this is the pure ghee which they are offering to God. You can see here, people are so excited in celebrating their festival. Look at their colorful dresses. The way the girls have dressed up, all are in the same dress with a dupatta and a headgear and hands full of bangles, and they are performing folk dance, folk singing on the road, celebrating this festival. Next one is the Hill Jatra festival. Hill Jatra. Hill Jatra yani festival, mela, jatra, fair. Hill yani mountain. So the Hill Jatra is amongst the traditional festivals celebrated in the state of Uttarakhand. specially in Pitoragraha district of Kumaon region. The festival is celebrated mainly by the people associated with farming in the state. During the festival, a white cloth deer is worshipped as a regional god. So the hill jatra, here you can see people in different colorful attire, different colorful dresses. They are wearing masks, they have decorated, they have painted their face, and this is all the tricks that they are performing on the tricks, entertaining the people, entertaining the tourists, exhibiting their happiness only to show that they are celebrating the festival. And what do? You can see here, this is the picture of a face mask of deer. They are going to offer, like here I told you, during the festival, a white cloth deer is worshipped as a regional god. So they offer a white cloth deer and they offer it and they worship it as a regional god. You can see here, this is all the tricks that they are performing on the roads. Yes, it is attracting people. Very happily they are enjoying it and the public is watching them. The next one, Khandali festival. The next one is Khandali festival. Khandali festival celebrated by the Rung tribe of Pitoragraha district. Khandali is a festival that commemorates the defeat of Zorawar Singh's army. The festival celebration includes singing of folk songs and uprooting of Khandali plant. The villagers celebrate by enjoying to the folk music and performing a special dance upon destruction of the plants blooming every 12 years. You can see the people are performing folk song, folk singing. You can see how nicely they are dressed up with all this kind of ornaments, with a headgear, and they are walking towards the temple. They are going in a procession, singing and dancing, enjoying the festival. From different parts of the village, people gather, they sing folk songs and they dance, they perform folk dances. You can see here again people are going in a large group in procession, carrying something on their shoulder. It is they are going towards the temple, offering. They want to go and offer themselves or whatever they have prayed, so that their visiting this place becomes fruitful. It is not only the localized people there, people from all over India go to this holy place. They are called as pilgrims. Okay, they go, stay there, spend time, visit all the temples, take darshan of all the gods and goddesses there, and they come back. You can see here the ladies, they are performing some folk dance. You see their dresses, how they are dressed up, see their ornaments, jewelries. Okay, they are performing some folk dance. This is all in public where they are attracting the crowds. Each one is trying to show his own performance, some tricks, some different kinds of martial arts. Some will show some tricks, some will do some gymnastics. Okay, this is how they celebrate their festivals, the people of Uttarakhand. You can see here again there are groups, you know, performing some drama through folk singing. Folk singing, they are doing, they are presenting. They are presenting a drama through folk singing. Here you can see during this festival. Will you be quiet? Will you be quiet?
Ma'am, we can't see your presentation. Someone is presenting.
Ma'am, yes, ma'am, I can't see the presentation.
You leave the meeting. If you can't see, if you can't see, then leave the meeting. I'll take the class tomorrow again for you. You're disturbing me. You're disturbing the class. Maybe there is a net issue in your system only.
No, ma'am.
During the festival, you don't disturb me now. If you can't see, then be quiet. I will send the link. See, I told you to mute your system, you did not listen. This is during the festival. There are funfair, melas are set up where they have different kinds of rides. It is like the merry-go-round, giant wheel. People gather there, they have fun, they enjoy. There are different kinds of rides. You can see here another group of people going towards the temple. They are taken, you know, big banners are there in their hand. They are singing the folk song or reciting some mantras or prayer, devotional songs, and going towards the temple because they have to climb the mountains and go to the temple. So they go in groups singing and dancing and reciting, you know, the prayers. And you can see the people here, they are carrying some palki, they are carrying the what we call as palki. Okay, in that you will see the statues or idols of God. Okay, so the people carry it from down to up the hill and they perform some puja in the temples. This is the holy place where people go and take a dip in the holy water and all their sins will be washed away. And they do it because they think that by taking a dip in the holy river, they become once again a pure person. This is the view of the entire place. You can see the amount of people gathered there. See the crowd. Everywhere you will find rushes. People are so busy visiting. People are so busy celebrating, enjoying themselves. Uttarayani festival, the next one held at several places is in Kumaon region. Uttarayani Mela marks the moving of sun from southern to northern hemisphere. This bright traditional fair is also an excellent venue to witness the rich culture and art of this region. A grand fair is held on the banks of the river Saryu in Bageshwar. You can see there is a Mela set up there. There are many kinds of rides. People are performing some dance there, folk dance. Yes, people go, enjoy and have fun and share their happiness with their relatives, friends. Yes, you can see here, people are in colorful dresses. They are performing folk dance. The men are singing. They are showing some martial arts. Yes, they are showing some martial art and the girls are performing folk dance. Look at their dress costumes, so colorful and so beautifully. They have decorated themselves with the ornaments. Uttarakhand is the only Indian state to have Sanskrit as one of its official language. Uttarakhand is the only Indian state to have Sanskrit as one of its official languages. Now the local language what they speak there is Hindi, Garhwali and Kumaoni language. So these are the three local language, and their official language is Sanskrit. Now before I end the session, now I want to just give you a small hint or a small information. State animal, it is the Himalayan musk. State animal is the Himalayan musk. State flower is the Brahma Kamal. State flower is the Brahma Kamal. And the state bird is the Himalayan Monal Pheasant. This is also called as the national bird of Nepal. And the state tree is the bronze. And the state tree is the bronze. Children, this is only about the festival of Uttarakhand. How people live, how people celebrate their festival, how they enjoy themselves, how they share their happiness with their relatives and neighbors and with the public. So, we being here, we have learned few things about the lifestyle of the people of Uttarakhand. In the same way, we can learn many things about many places without going there. It is a part of India. It is on the mountains. People there, at times, they face a lot of problems because sometimes it is heavily raining there, too much of rainfall. Sometimes the weather is too cold there because of the ice, and during summer it is extreme hot. So the people, yet they face all these difficulties, they face all this problem, and they are so happy. They trust God because Uttarakhand is called as the land of gods. It is called as Dev Bhumi. It is the Dev, it is the God who is protecting them and helping them to survive there in all situations. We have to learn so many things from the people of Uttarakhand because they sacrifice so many things and they are yet living in that place, even in that critical situation. They face so many problems and yet they regain back their normal life and start their normal life. So children, this was a small presentation by English teacher. Okay, a virtual trip to Uttarakhand. We have learned or we have seen or we got information about the festivals celebrated there. There in the sense in Uttarakhand.